shortly after, in the first year of that show, there was an internecine warfare between Mita Rosenberg and Roy Huggins. And Roy had worked with Jim Gardner on the early Mavericks, but Mita was Jim's manager and agent who had become the executive producer, and they did not get along. So Roy departed, and all of the people who Roy had hired, a couple of the producers left. And one of the people who left was the associate producer. So I'm still in the production coordination department as their production coordinator. And literally, the phone rang one day, and it was Mita and Steve. And they were now running the show, and Roy had sort of stepped back. And they said, come down and talk to us. And I went down, and they said, how would you like to be our associate producer? Well, the interesting thing about the story is that I had still been pursuing acting on the side. And you weren't allowed to act and work in production. SAG didn't really allow it, and the studios didn't allow it, but I did. And I was I had a couple of roles on Toma, which I was also a production coordinator on. I did a $6 million man. I did a Kojak at that time with Telly Savalas. And the interesting thing about the Kojak was it was one of Sylvester Stallone's first roles, and I played a young cop who replaced him. So I was acting at the same time. So when they offered me the associate producer job, I was going, well, I'm just starting to also act, and that's what I really wanted to do. But they said, think about it, you know, and I went home by myself, and I thought about it, and I thought, you can always act probably, but you're not going to be offered every day a chance to be an associate producer. And so I opted to take the job, and, you know, that was the beginning of a long career in 1974 as the associate producer on the Rockford Files.